you give them something to eat. Notice that word, you. You do this. And what did the disciples say? They said, shall we go and spend 200 denarii on bread and give them something to eat? He said, how many loaves do you have? And they said, well, we have 5 loaves and 2 fish. You know, they were saying, Jesus, what you're asking is ridiculous. If we had $10,000, put it in today's vernacular, we had $10,000, it wouldn't be enough to buy Subway subs and chips and soda for the people. By man's power, the task was impossible. But Jesus doesn't depend on man's power. And we should not. We should be on our knees saying, God, I don't understand, but I know you have a plan. Help me understand your plan. And he commanded them, verse 39, he commanded them to all recline in the groups of the greens. And they reclined in the companies of hundreds and fifties, and he took the 5 loaves and 2 fishes. And looking toward heaven, he blessed the food and broke the loaves. And he kept giving to the disciples, set before them, and he divided the 2 fish among them all. And they all ate and were satisfied. And then what happened? He took a Sabbath rest. Siesta. They picked up the 12 loaves. They picked up the 12 baskets. Picked up the extra pieces of bread and fish. 5,000 men ate that day, plus their wives and their children. Jesus blessed beyond their imagination. Jesus is calling you to a mission. And he needs you to say yes. The disciples said, Lord, this is ridiculous. And there may be some times when you're tempted to say, this is ridiculous. Just think with William Miller, when his nephew came and knocked on the door and said, Mr. Miller, would you come and preach this Sunday at our church about the prophecies? And what did William Miller do? You may remember what he did. He got mad. And what else did he do? Pardon?
Great.
Well, he didn't get to that part yet. He'll eventually get there.
He went out into the maple trees.
Yeah, went to the maple trees, and he started arguing with God. How dare you ask me to do this?
Well, he made a covenant with him.
He made a covenant. Lord, whatever you want, I'll do. And the Lord said, okay, I want you to start preaching. And William Miller was so angry with God, kicking dust and dirt everywhere. Then he prayed. Then he came back and said, okay. That's what the disciples were doing. They were saying, Lord, this is impossible.
Yeah, but Pastor, didn't the disciples have a meeting without Jesus, and that's a part of the problem here?
Yes.
That's why they were wanting them to send them away. If they'd had a meeting with Jesus, they would have known what to do in the first place.
That's right. If they'd been open, if their hearts had been open. Remember, this is not the first time they fed 5,000. This is not the first time that Jesus quieted the waters. This is not the first time they'd seen miracles. They just were not focused on God. They're focused on themselves.
Amen.
And for us to be faithful to the mission that God is calling us to be, we must focus on God.
Amen.
Yes, there'll be rejections. But God promises to empower us, to give us the authority to be faithful to the mission He has given to us. And yes, there will be trials, just as John experienced. And yes, there'll be times when we'll say, Lord, what exactly do you want? We have a professor at Southern whose birthplace is Syria, and he has a nephew who became a Christian, and three of his closest friends trying to kill him. He eventually had the privilege of leading those three to Christ. But his nephew's mission that God had given him was to pastor Seventh-day Adventist Church in Syria. You think it's bad that you can't buy Bibles on the internet in China? Syria. To be a Christian is a death sentence. So we need to keep praying for that little Adventist church in Syria. To be faithful to the mission that God has called. And we need to ask, Lord, what about me? What is the mission you want? Because God has promised to empower us and to give us the authority. The question is, will you accept God's authority? Would you rather follow him? So I'd like to invite you to spend this week wrestling with that. Lord, what is your mission for me? Now maybe you have a clear idea already what it is. And so I invite you to stand with me and to dedicate ourselves today and say, Lord, give me a clear calling. What mission it is you want me to follow. Tell me not to be distracted, but to bathe that mission in prayer and to have total confidence in you. Let's pray. Lord, you've given this church mission, a purpose, and it's been fulfilled in a variety of ways, through prison ministry, through feeding the homeless, through Christmas store, through Bible studies, and the list goes on and on. But Lord, you also give each and every one of us specific missions. And Lord, sometimes those missions can be terrifying. But help us to trust you. Help us to rely on you. Help us not to be intimidated by man's size understanding, but to recognize that you're calling us and that you give us the authority, the power to be effective for you. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Everybody standing, so we'll take your hymnals out and we'll sing to heaven too.
Through the nation, travel.
place of refuge, that you are our shelter, and most of all, that you are sovereign. That you understand all the issues that we're facing and the issues that we will face in the future. Help us to have the courage to not only seek you, but to trust you. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
One day she'll think she's